Measuring frames per second is a common way to talk about an application as a whole. If an application runs at 10 frames per second on one system and 20 frames per second on another, we can truthfully say the second system is about twice as fast in this instance. However, graphics programmers themselves have been moving towards using the inverse of frames per second, milliseconds per frame. There are a number of good reasons for this. The most appealing one to me is that milliseconds give you a solid number for use in comparison of different algorithms. If you talk about an algorithm's implementation in terms of milliseconds per frame, you can then treat the effect on speed as a single number. This user interface is costing us 5 milliseconds per frame is a useful fact in its own right. This user interface slows us down by 10 frames per second is not all that helpful, since we don't know what the frame rate was before. Rating individual parts of the rendering process by frames per second doesn't make a lot of sense, since it's the sum of the costs that's important. You can add millisecond costs together to see how much a frame will typically take. Games, for example, will often have a budget, say, of 33.3 milliseconds per frame, which means 30 frames per second. If different effects cost various amounts of time, it's easier to add these up and see if we're over budget. If an application aims for 60 frames per second, the budget's halved. Another reason to avoid frames per second is that they're difficult to work with mathematically. So, of course, that's what I'm going to ask you to do to get a feel for this sort of problem. You measure your application. Say it's a walkthrough of a building. Here are the rates you find. 25 frames per second for 100 frames, 50 frames per second for the next 100 frames, 25 frames per second for the next 100 frames, and then 10 frames per second for the last 100 frames of your benchmark. What is the average speed of the application in frames per second? I'll give you a hint. Simply averaging the frames per second values is not going to work. Think about how many frames are rendered and how many seconds pass during the entire benchmark. You might want to translate this problem to thinking about miles per hour.